Hello, this is Dr. Hassan with Innovate, and this is a list of courses offered by Innovate as of October 17, 2020, updated on October 17, 2020. You can see our email, it is innovatellc@gmail.com. Our website is innovatellc.org. The next is a disclaimer for you to read. Professional developments, any course that we offer can be held at your site, online. You can contact us, innovatellc@gmail.com. Innovate offers professional development, continuing education, training. We provide on-site courses at your location, face-to-face, anywhere in the States, and online anywhere in the world. Innovate provide basic courses and in-depth practical knowledge and skills needed in science and technology. Our courses keep you current with the technology needed, provide better, faster, and cheaper solutions for complex systems. We are up to date on the latest developments and innovations, and we want to keep you up to date on the latest developments and innovations. If you do not find the course that you need, Innovate can also prepare and offer any on-site or online course tailored to your needs. Please contact us at innovatellc@gmail.com for your proposal. For on-site or online pricing, also please contact us at the same email, innovatellc@gmail.com. Any participant to any of our courses will receive a certificate of completion upon the completion of any course. Now, the first section of our courses is Engineering Innovations, and we have four courses, CE1004, CE1014, CE1024, and CE1034. CE1004 is Introduction to Engineering, Survey of the Scopes of Engineering Major and Majors and Engineers' Role in Society, an Engineer's Role in Society, Professional Issues including Ethics, Sustainability, and History of Engineering Professions will be covered, Basic Engineering Tools Used in Simulation and Modeling will be also discussed, an Introduction to the Concepts of Engineering Analysis and Design. Comprehensive set of notes will be supplied to all. The next course is CE1014, Creativity and Innovation. This course deals really explore creativity and innovation in terms of assisting every participant to release their innate abilities in creativities and innovations. We will discuss 29 different sections that you can read here. And all is intends really to develop new the ability to create and create. Comprehensive sets of notes will provide. Next course, CE1024, the Creative Thinking Techniques. This course will teach you how to become an innovator, especially with breakthrough innovations. So it is a very important course for patients, any individual intends become very successful innovator. The next course is CE1034, Innovate with TRIZ. TRIZ stands for Theory of Innovative Problem Solving, and this course will enable you to solve problems and products. This is the intent of this course, by using TRIZ. Now, in Electrical and Computer Engineering section, we offer many courses on 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000, and 6,000 levels, and starting with the CE2004 Digital Systems Introduction of this course, you can find it on my YouTube channel, the course on Innovate LLC YouTube channel. This course introduces number systems and conversions, introduces the design and analysis of combinational circuits, gates, Boolean algebra, and sequential circuits, mainly clock sequential circuits, and synchronous and asynchronous networks. So a very intensive course and very useful course, and also we have advanced digital systems coming soon. CE 2014 Electric Circuits 1 covered resistive circuits, nodal loop analysis, Thevenin's and Norton's, and capacitance, inductance, first order transient circuit, and second order transient circuits. This course intended to be the first course in circuits for engineering participants. CE 2024 Signals and Systems. This course covers fundamental signals and systems, discrete and continuous, Z transform, Laplace transform, Fourier representation. Again, very important course with many applications in communications and signal processing. The continuation of Electric Circuits 1 is Electric Circuits 2, which focuses on sinusoids, phasors, sinusoidal steady analysis, Laplace and Fourier transforms, and also covers periodic and aperiodic input sources, non-sinusoidal as well as sinusoidal sources. CE3024, microprocessors and microcomputers. This course explains the technology of microprocessors and how to use a microprocessor to build a microcomputer. We will build a simple microcomputers and complex sophisticated microcomputers with many applications. Solid-state electronics, CE3034, this course deals with the inside of the semiconductor material. Talking about conductivity, magnetic properties, optical properties, thermal properties of devices with emphasis on diodes, bipolar transistors, and MOSFETs. CE3044 Electronics, the objective of this course is develop the ability to analyze and design analog electronic circuits, discrete and integrated. Topics include bias, feedback amplifiers, power amplifiers, power supplies, voltage regulators, and etc. Very important course. CE4004 Advanced Digital Systems, this course covers advanced topics in digital design, digital system design using ASM chart, register transfer level, design of UART and design of microcontroller, design for testability. Very important course, and this is the second course in digital systems. So we have digital systems and advanced digital systems. Automotive electronics, this is deal with the electronics in every vehicle, from sensors to actuators to controllers, to the battery system, anything related to the wire harnesses, even touch and wire harnesses, anything, all electronics related to the automotive industry, you find this course. Very intensive course and useful course if you seek a career in automotive technology. CE4024 electromagnetic compatibility. Every electronic circuit will have electromagnetic issues, and it has to be electromagnetic compatible to avoid many problems like noise and like magnetic field and so on and so forth. So to design actually an electronic circuit that meets the legal standards or requirements of electromagnetic, you need to understand this course. Very important as well, and has a lot of applications in automotive designs. CE4034, electrical systems design. This is a career course when you work with architects to design the electrical systems of industrial, residential, or commercial establishments. So you need all the wiring and the harnesses and variety of loads, and you need to be in compliance with the national electrical. And you need to be licensed to do that. You need to have a PE, professional engineering license. CE4044, Advanced Electronics. This is the second course in the sequence of electronics and advanced electronics. Emphasis on operational amplifier design and applications, advanced power supply design, switch capacitor design, frequency converters, insulation amplifiers, and triangular sine wave converters and oscillators. OT54, see if OT54 communication systems, this is the first course in communication systems in a sequence of courses. This is deals with analog communication system, AM, FM, PCM, pulse code modulation. Then we will touch on coding a bit. Okay, multiple access channel, broadcast channel, Gaussian noise, and time varying channels. So it is basically analog, very simple introduction to digital communication systems. CE4064 control systems. This deals with analog control systems, how to control system using a feedback, so feedback systems. CE4074, power electronics. This course examines the application of electronics to energy conversion and control, DC-DC converters, and switching power supplies, rectifiers, inverters. Very important course if you deal in electronics applications and applications as well. CE4084, electric machines. This course will teach you the electric machineries, generators, motors, all electromechanical systems and applications in mechatronics. And 4094, mechatronics. This is the synergic combination of mechanical, electronics, and systems. We design real systems. This is a very important course, mechatronics, and course very similar to systems engineering that we as well. So CE4094, highly it is in mechatronics. Embedded systems or microcontrollers. This course will teach you the hardware and the software, the framework of microcontrollers with applications. Computer architecture, classification, process data path, and control, microprogram architectures, instruction, arithmetic pipeline, RISC versus CISC computer, and architecture of selective microprocessors and ALUs and CPUs. Data communication networks. This course focuses on the fundamentals of data communication networks. Topic discussed in layered network architecture, link layer protocol, ISP packet switching, queuing theory, local area networks, and wide area networks. Comprehensive set of notes will also supply. CE4134, real-time systems, hardware and software framework, real-time computer systems, introduction to real-time scheduling, synchronization, and operating system commands, and real-time programming languages. Very important course if you are interested in real-time applications. Antennas and propagation. This course covers the fundamentals of antennas and many applications, starting with propagation theory and propagation. So this is deals with communication systems, and it's very useful. Radar technology and propagation effect, comprehensive set of notes. Electronic noise controls, CE4154. This course covers system noise sources, noise spectral density and circuit calculations, noise and feedback, system noise figure, noise temperature and bandwidth, correlation and noise problem, noise reduction techniques, digital circuit, noise and operation, electromagnetic compatibility design techniques, comprehensive set of notes also provided. CE4164, Optoelectronics, electromagnetic theory, fundamentals of lasers, propagation, optical beams and fibers, optical fiber systems, photosensors, emitting diodes, optical isolators, and couplers. So we'll talk about optics. Optics is a very intensive field and really cannot be covered in one course, but we'd like to cover as much as we can in this course. Process control, also called programmable logic controllers and applications. We'll talk about view of PLCs and relay ladder logic, electrical schematic symbols, PID controllers and applications. Digital image processing, this is visual information plays an important role. Digital imaging classes is a very important subject, and in the recognition, restoration, acceleration, feature extraction, and modeling of thresholding images, improving quality of images. Very, very intensive field, digital image processing. Machine vision is a continuation to image processing, provide intensive information to process generating symbolic description of environment by imaging. Lectures describe the physics of image formation, machine vision, and it's all really related to machine vision, it's object detection, target recognition, character recognition, even voice recognition related to this. Okay, and we can find we are not, we will add a course in voice recognition, which is very related to machine vision. Okay. Applications to robotics and intelligent machine interaction are also discussed. CE 5024, Digital Integrated Circuits, examines the device and circuit localization digital building block. So this is a continuation to the Advanced Digital System course. Analog Integrated Circuit Design, this is a continuation to the Advanced Electronics course. We will design operational amplifier, analog amplifier, digital to analog, and analog digital converters, comparators, GMC filters, and so on and so forth. CE 5044, VLSI system design. This is deal with the VLSI technology and how the integrated circuit is designed. Talking about semi-custom and custom design approaches, what happens inside the clean loop integrated circuit design. Digital Communication, CE 5054. This course serves really the digital communication channel, data compression, coding, variety of codes used in transferring data, and to avoid noise in the digital channel and wireless communication channel. So the 5054 is very important in digital communication. Once the signal is converted from analog to digital, so you are really in the digital side, digital world, and the digital world you like to transmit data reliably and to avoid white Gaussians. So this is very important course in digital communication. Wireless communication is a continuous digital communication. Introduce the design, analysis, and fundamental of wireless transmission systems. Wireless channel and system models, fading and diversity, resource management, and multiple antenna and MIM systems, multi-input, multi-output systems, space-time and coding, and variety of technologies and topologies are covered in wireless communication. Optical communication deals with optical transmitters and optical receivers, and how we transmit data, modulated data through fiber optics. So optical communication is a very important field where most of the data of the internet now converted to optical communication to give you a very, very high super speed data throughput. CE 5084 digital control systems. This is again using the computer as a digital controller. Digital control system became a very important task. And this course uses basically Z-transform, sampling, and reconstruction. Digital controller design with many industrial applications. The next course is CE 5094, Digital Signal Processing. The course addresses the creation, analysis, and design of discrete signals and systems, and design digital filters. Now, CE 5104, Advanced Computer Architecture. This is the second course of a sequence of two courses in computer architecture. We will talk about power processing, memory and I/O subsystem, pipeline and processing, and a variety of advanced topics in computer architecture. mainly multi-processor systems and very large number of processor systems. This is very advanced technology, and many papers coming out in this technology. Passive network synthesis. This is deals with LC and FC circuit synthesis using passive and covered network techniques, transfer function synthesis, then low pass approximation, passive realization of low pass, band pass, high pass, and pass networks and filters. Very important course if you are dealing with circuits and systems and passive networks analysis. Active network synthesis deals with building Op-amp circuits, Op-amp oscillators, delay filters, switch capacitor filters, phase equalization, low pass, band pass, high pass, and pass networks using active components, which is the Op-amp, and we will look at the operational imperfections and nonlinear operations. Electronic communications, very interesting course that deals with electronic systems from the circuit point of view. Very important course to show you how to build modulators, demodulators, RF amplifiers, oscillators, and so on and so forth. Automatic gain control, even filters, and power supply regulations. Satellite communications. This is an introductory course, focuses on satellites and telecommunication networks, satellite communication provider competitiveness, very important satellite Earthlink to understand satellite, even when it on satellite, atmospheric effects and propagation of signals. Okay. Adaptive control systems deal with systems that variable with variable characteristic equation. So how to do control such system, and we do something called adaptive control. And very interesting subject, very high level course, and this is what it's a 6,000 course. Artificial intelligence, this course introduces artificial expert system topics and representation and influence in first order logic, modern deterministic and decision planning techniques, basic supervised learning method, Bayesian network inference and learning, fuzzy set theory, fuzzy reasoning, decision theories. Machine learning, this is an introductory course in machine learning, which gives an overview of many concepts, techniques, and algorithms in machine learning, beginning with topics such as classification, and linear regression, ending up with more recent topics such as boosting, support vector machines, hidden Markov models, and Bayesian networks. How to teach a machine? This is all about machine learning. 6034, radio frequency integrated circuit. This is deals with a specific application in integrated circuit design with the radio frequency range, with priority focus on placing high-speed communication circuit using in wireless and data link communications. Topics include transmission line, high power and low noise amplifier, oscillator, control oscillators, mixer, power amplifiers, high speed digital circuits, and frequency synthesizers. How to build a successful radio frequency integrated circuits is the goal of this course. Advanced digital communication, which is CE 6044. This is the second course in digital communication, deals with the variety of code above and beyond the Shannon-Lemon of additive white Gaussian noise channels. So focuses on code techniques for approaching the Shannon limit, not above and beyond, approaching the Shannon additive white Gaussian noise, which is AWGN channels, their performance analysis and design principles. Many codes came out, Reed Solomon, ECH codes, and binary linear block codes and Torres-based decoding codes, and so on and so forth. So many advanced coding techniques used in digital communication to have a successful, very high throughput digital networks, and by avoiding these defined early priorities by China. This is the second course, CE6054, Advanced Satellite Communications, that deals with communication systems and satellite communication antennas, uplink, downlink, and composite performance, link budgets, and successful satellite communication systems. And in systems engineering, we have a number of courses, 51, 54, 55, 16, 517 4 up to 6104. Let's look at these courses. Introduction to Systems Engineering. This is an overview of system engineering principles and concepts, starting with the definition of systems to the process of design with considerations of uncertainty, risk, and hazards. The course is divided to four portions: introductory and the role of humans. And this the second portion of the course is spent on concept and development stage for the complex systems. And finally, actually, we propose development and special topics areas covered in this course. CE5164 system architecting, the system architecting concept, architectures and architecting and connecting method, capabilities of engineering as a top-down method to define architectures from above, defining the desired operational capabilities for a system, business, or enterprise. This is a very important course in system architecture. Systems of systems, due to the complexity of current systems, so we have systems of systems. For instance, a hospital consists of numerous number of systems, from electrical to cleaning system to air conditioning system to emergency system. So we have so many systems in one system, which is a hospital. So how we integrate, so we look at integrations, strategies, collaboration, how things can work all together in SOS environment. 6064, Requirements Engineering. This is an intensive course in requirements engineering, how to generate requirements, how to classify requirements, successful design of systems of systems. Then we'll talk about requirements-driven design, CE6074. Risk-driven design in 6084, human-centered design in 6094, 6104, which is concentrate on model-based design. And this is the end courses. We have about more than approximately 60 courses, just about 60 courses. These courses are very important. Again, we may update this list at any time. I thank you so much. Please subscribe and see you soon in the next lectures.